My name's Paul, and I'll play Larry.
No, Larry Mutton. Larry Mutton, Jamie.
Yes, man.
My name's Peter, and I'll play Adam.
Playtime.
Playtime.
And I'm Andy Ambonio Biscuit.
And allow myself to introduce myself. My name's Gordon, and I'm the Hedge.
Well, about 1988, I think.
Yes.
Oh, no, 1989. Yeah, it was after Rattling Home. And you two were recording the new album and decided to take a break and go to South America. Actually, no, Bahamas.
Mm-hmm.
And the plane sort of went to the Bermuda Triangle and disappeared. But came out the other end. And there was a bit of sort of shenanigans going on. And two bands came out. There was you two went on to do what they did, and we were born from the other side, sort of doppelganger, sort of split personalities.
And do you two know about this?
It happened.
I don't know, actually. No. They might do.
Yeah, they do.
They might, because they're going to be missing certain parts of the personality now.
That's true, yeah.
Yeah, they're going to be totally
adopted.
We've taken the humour aspect.
Yeah. We've taken the piss take.
Yeah.
So how did you all get together then? What happened? Who started it? Whose idea was it?
We're all brothers.
No.
Like the cause.
Just like the cause.
Dublin, Belfast, we were nervous, very nervous whether we would go down, being an English group coming over, you know,
yeah.
Course of Newcastle type of thing. But it went down great, and everything's gone great since then. Whether we're in Belfast, whether we're in Dublin, whether we're down in Cork, Galway, it's always been great, and the reactions always have been good reactions.
Great venue.
Absolutely brilliant
great
venues.
So it is great for years.
And the people are just out for a good time.
That's a
It is different. In England, people are a bit more reserved.
More cynical.
Yeah, they're very cynical. Very cynical. Mm. I don't want to paint a bad picture of it, but like, it is just so...
I hear it.
It is so much better over here.
The thing is, there's a culture of live music in pubs and in clubs and venues.
Yeah.
Whereas in England, if you walk into a pub and somebody's in the corner playing, everybody's talking over them. It's interesting.
U2 when they were the best, the classics.
Mm-hmm.
We're not saying that U2 don't do good stuff now, because the last album was superb, it's brilliant.
Yeah.
But when you're doing tribute, we focus. Yeah, we focus on the nostalgia part of it, you know, when they were at their height. And people can go and see them do the pop mart and whatever now, but they can't go and see them with their hats and their waistcoats. You know, they can't see that anymore, so we did that.
That's a good point, actually.
Well, a lot of more successful tribute bands are from bands that don't exist or are dead.
Mm-hmm.
Now you two obviously still go on, so you've got to do something that you can't get, and you can't see that anymore, so that's what we do.
What about D-Witched?
D-Witched, yeah. There's a band
that's
called D-Witched.
Yeah. Really?
They play
their
Empire.
Yeah. I don't quite
like to
see them,
yeah.
I'm sorry. Thank you. feel about tonight that you'd be presented with the Freedom of Kildare?
It is a great honour.
Yeah, we're really honoured.
It is.
Yeah, I'll not sleep.
I'm choking up.
I look forward to meeting the mayor.
Yeah, the mayor of Kildare.
Is the mayor coming?
I don't know, but I hope he is.
Well, actually, that's only because he wants.
Is there not a mayor?
We're looking forward to getting some free chips.
It's a copper
mayor. Well, as we've mentioned earlier, there is a little secret chip shop hidden in someone's house around the corner.
Yeah.
Apparently, we're going to get free chips.
Great chips.
And Neil, who runs this place, says that we can have free Guinness and champagne for our special night, which is nice. Thanks.